that.
So, you know, yeah. These two guys right here, my two other brothers, man, Tone Loke and Mousy, you know, they basically raised me, you know what I'm saying? You know, these are my peers that I grew up with, and, you know, if I wasn't acting on point, they'd have me on point, man, and very big part of 17 Reasons, Black and Brown. They are what we are, you know. We live this shit every day. I let them introduce themselves. And some of the things, Tone, I kind of want you to talk about is, you know, the art history, you know, on the freeway, maybe on the Skylark, and you know.
Man. Hey,
boy, talk to me.
Man. I'm Tone Loke's cousin. That's Tone Loke's cousin, man. If y'all know him, you know what I'm saying, focus in.
My name is, that's my new rap name is Tone Loke's cousin. He got hella shit coming out. You're gonna love it.
And somebody's mom will be involved.
Yes. And grandmothers are getting younger, so somebody's grandma might be involved.
Come out, let's go through it, man. So, okay. How did you get in this rap game? What do you remember?
Oh shit.
When we first met.
That was not a good sound.
That was not. My shit's good. When we first met.
Well, just tell me the story about how it went down and how you got in that studio to do Northside Soldiers because it's first rap career.
All right. Well, I was on 24th and Cap, kicking it, in McDonald's parking lot, and Mexican and this black dude, it's like a joke. There was this Mexican and this black dude, they pull up in front of us. It was me and some of the homies kicking it, and they get out the car and Gold Toes. Well, he was Julio then, he wasn't even Gold Toes yet, he was just Julio, right? He gets out the car, you know what I'm saying? He introduced himself. He had the little business card for Savage Management because it wasn't even fucking Black and Brown yet, and he was looking for me, you know what I'm saying? Because fucking at that time, I was just like, well, motherfuckers have a wedding or a party, I'll just get fucked up and hop on there and start rapping over instrumental records. And so I guess he had heard one of my tapes or some shit like that. So he came down to 24, you know what I'm saying, looking for me because he wanted a homie to be on 17 Reasons, right? So he asked for me, one of my little homies was like, man, what you want with the homie? And I'm looking at him, I'm trying to decide, like, damn. I'm saying, what, do we get on him before or something? And but it's like, nah, man. Like, here, you gave him the business card. So I took the business card. I was like, he's like, you're Mousy? I was like, yeah. And he's like, well, shit, bro. Hey, just hit me up whenever you want to get in the studio. Well, obviously, I had heard that bullshit before. So I was like, all right. So I just put that shit in my pocket and forgot about it. So like a couple weeks later, I was at the house. And I was chirped out. And I was snorting with that card, right? And then I looked at that shit and I was like, man, this bullshit ass nigga right here. He called us, motherfucker. But he was fucking Page somebody at the time, though. Feel me? So a couple minutes later, calls back. Yo, what's up? And I was like, what's up? And then fucking, I was like, what's up? It's Mousy. I want to get in the studio right now. And he's like, where you at? And I told him, and it turned out we live right around the corner from each other. Didn't even know it. So shit, motherfucker got me in the studio that day, though. So fucking, half-ass kept his word, you know what I'm saying? So about 2 weeks later, we did Northside Soldier, which was my first song that fucking was done in an actual studio. Everything else was just, you know what I'm saying, a mic, a turntable, and a tape recorder, you know what I'm saying? But you know what I'm saying, after that, everything just, man, my life has changed and hasn't changed since.
So let me ask you this. Tell them about how that Northside Soldier, you had that rap for how long before you laid it down?
I laid it down. Shit.
Because you had it written in the penitentiary.
Nah, that's the thing though. We recorded two different versions of Northside Soldier, right? And one of them was with Louis Loke, and they decided to just go with the other song that I did. You know what I'm saying? And but that one right there, I did on spot. You know what I mean? But the other one that was with the shit with Louis Loke, that was already written. I wrote that when I was in the pen.
Is there anything else you want to talk about? That you have a bunch of unreleased. Okay, you ready?
Oh yeah, I got hella shit.
So look, right now we just went through a bunch of unreleased music. You got stuff with Woody. You got stuff with Louis Loke. You got stuff with Gangsta Fleet.
Yeah.
I mean, this shit is sounding nice. I mean, it's on hit. The only thing about it is you was running the streets basically. Why didn't you come out with it? You know, it's not going to be fully mixed as we planned it to be.
Because when I got arrested on this thing, I went to the pen for. The gang task force came and took all my shit, and I had so many recorded songs complete songs, and then all kinds of files with just verses and hooks and shit in them, or just beats, and they took all that shit. But I used to do so much shit because I had the studio in my house. I used to have to dump the shit off out of the computer onto data discs. Well, one of my baby mamas was caught herself, trying to be a fag to me, and took my shit. I didn't even notice it. So then, fucking, like 6 years later, when I get out of prison, you know what I'm saying? I was being nice to her one day, and she gave that shit back to me. I was like, what the fuck is this? I took it home, and I was like, oh shit, and came up with like 80 songs just like that.
So let me ask, how many albums you got out right now for the record, man? You got Mousy.
Just one.
To the Curb.
Yeah. Lifestyles as a Broken Scandalous.
And the new Black and Brown Mousy coming out.
Right.
That's coming soon.
Very soon. Hella soon.
That's right.